In the past few weeks, ChargerLAB has torn down several MagSafe products, but we forgot the Apple standard MagSafe charger. So after a year since the release, let's see what looks like inside of this charger. The packaging, okay, obviously Apple style. Compatible information and system requirements are printed on the side. Product model A2140 is on the other side. It supports input of 5V 3A and 9V 2.2A. It is recommended to use a 20W charger, which is the same as the MagSafe dual charger. Open the box. Only MagSafe charger and some documents. It comes with USB-C cable and the junction of the cable and the charging pad has been protected. The button and edge of the charging pad adopt aluminum alloy shell. The top surface is rubber, feels like skin. The length of the cable is about 1 meter. The diameter is about 56 millimeter and the thickness is about 5 millimeter. Then let's take a look at its capability. 5 on 12 series, it can basically maintain 15 watts. But as for Android phones, most of them can only support 5 watts. AirPods Pro will be 2 watts. After the appearance and performance, let's tear it down. Firstly is the USB-C port. The inside PCB is reinforced and protected by shield sheets. There are multiple chips on the front and back of the PCB, a moist fat is in the middle. There is Type-C controller which comes from Cypress CYPD2104. This big chip comes from Texas Instruments, remove it with heat gun. We found it's the boost converter used to boost the input voltage and power the charger. Model is TPS61178. So we can speculate that Apple's 15W wireless charging is step up from the basis of 7.5W. And use the charge pump to step down. The Schottky diode next to it comes from Owen Semiconductor and is used to improve conversion efficiency. This alloy inductor is used for boosting. It can be seen that this product is very high qualified, cause the input design is so complicated. Next, let's tear down the charging pad. Remove the upper cover. We can see the charging coil is in the middle, which is fixed and reinforced by glue. The plastic ring can isolate the magnets and coil. The PCB is at the bottom of the charging pad and fixed by glue. The magnet ring on the edge is composed of multiple small magnets and is also fixed by glue. Back to the PCB, the front is covered with a shield and there are two holes on the shield. Then remove it by heating with a heat gun. So this small PCB has two parts, the control part and the wireless charging part. Here is the MPS step-down chip which is used to power the microcontroller. This is temperature detection chip which comes from Texas Instruments TMP302. It can be used for temperature detection and overheating protection. The master control chip comes from STMicroelectronics. It has high performance basic series MCU with DSP and FPU. And it also has 512KB flash, 180MHz CPU, ART accelerator, and dual QSPI. This is wireless charging controller customized by STMicroelectronics and packaged by CSP. It has built-in MOSFET driver. There are two MOSFETs used to drive the wireless charging coil. Those are 4W MPO resonant capacitors and they are connected in parallel. Well, that will be all components of this charger. This charger adopts a very complicated boost circuit and puts it into the USB-C cable. As the standard wireless charger for iPhone 12, its suppliers will be benefited, such as STMicroelectronics and Texas Instruments. But for customers, its charging speed is still a little bit slow and the heating problem still exists. Okay, that's all for today's video. Hope you'll like it and can subscribe to us. You can also click the left side to see other Teardown videos about Apple products. See you next time. Bye!